Gryffindor. No, I think it was Hufflepuff. Wait a second, Ravenclaw? For sure it was not Slytherin. Hey guys, welcome back. You know, I have been a die-hard Harry Potter fan, like finishing one book a day during my summer vacation. Sadly, the children of today don't really know this book much. Today's video is going to be about reviewing a few characters and telling you what I learned from them. Alohomora, let's just get going. So I'm going to be starting with, guess who? Hermione Jean Granger, the brightest witch of her age. Hermione Granger taught me a lot of good things, especially that being prepared for class is not to be considered outcast. Though your friends might not really enjoy your brilliance in the starting, it will surely come in handy to them. Always stay prepared for your class. Hermione also taught me that it doesn't matter if you were a pureblood or a muggle-born or a half-blood. What matters is that you using your inner potential to get where you are and not letting society decide where you get to. In the trio, without Hermione, the other two wouldn't even last a day. So cheers to Hermione Granger, I really love you. Keep calm and study like Granger. The next character is probably the sweetest character in the entire series and really underrated, but I really like him, Neville Longbottom. He showed us that even if you're not the brightest student in class and all the mishaps happen with you, you'll still do good in life. You'll still be a professor at Hogwarts. He taught me it's not a bad thing to mess up because at least you spread a good laughter. Neville also, right in the first book, shows us that it's in the difficult moments that actually our courage should stand out. More so when we stand up against our own friends. Sometimes in our day-to-day life, we can also see situations where we are either asked for a movie or to go out on this party night when you know that it's really important for you to study. Stick up to your friends when you know you're right. That's what I learned from Neville Longbottom. The next character is a little more eccentric. She is Luna Lovegood. A character that was portrayed in the book to be lost in her own world. So what I learned from Luna Lovegood is it doesn't matter if people call us by different names. If you believe strongly in something, do stick with it. In the end, your uniqueness will be what saves the day. Hey Luna Lovegood! The character of Luna also shows us how we can look for beauty in everything in life. Everything in life can become exciting, just like how Luna saw the beauty in a tesserol. It's really possible for everyone to find beauty in everything that they can see in life. This one, personally, is my favorite character in the entire series of Harry Potter. Albus Percival Wulfric Brian Dumbledore, aka Professor Dumbledore. He is my favorite character. What is so good about him? Well, I don't know where to start, actually. It's so nice the way he interacts with his students, makes them feel so wanted. At each stage, you really know he is one person you can truly look up to. Though he had many ambitions in life and in some way went towards them, he also knew in his right minds what is good for him. He stood up for it till the very end, till his last breath. It shows us that we need to have the conviction to do the right over what we desire to do. This is the true nature of Albus Dumbledore. We all know that Dumbledore could have gone ahead and ruled the world with Grindelwald. But instead, he decided that he wanted to stay on the good side and help the students and help the community coming up. We also know that in the third book, Dumbledore trusts Hermione to go back in time to save Buckbeak and Sirius. Such an important job that was left to such a young child. He knew that potential could be seen in anyone, and just because they are young and small doesn't mean they can't do big and think right. This is what Dumbledore taught me. Now, this character I'm going to tell you about is one of the most controversial characters in the entire Harry Potter series, Professor Snape. Is he good? Is he not good? Is he good? Is he not good? He's definitely not good. Oh my god, he's the sweetest character in Harry Potter. This is our chain of events when we think about Snape. Snape really put it out there. He told us that Nobody in the class needs to know that you are the good one as long as you are the good one. You don't have to portray yourself to be right and in the right path always. Just know it in your heart that you need to be there. Snape also taught us that love, true love, can never fade away and it always exists forever. His love for Lily Potter extended to always. And Snape, I will love you always. Fred and George, a twin that can really crack us up at any time. Fred and George taught us that school can be really fun if you want it to be so. It doesn't mean that you do not excel in magic. It just shows that you're a little too good for school. Fred and George really made it great in life, though they were this extremely fun-loving and all-over-the-place brothers in school. I mean, Peeves respected them. That is surely another league altogether. It's so cool that they're born on the 1st of April, the April Fool's Day, and they turn out to be so funny and hilarious always. Even in difficult times, we can find that one moment to crack a joke. Holy. Now, moving on to the protagonist of the series, Mr. Harry James Potter. Harry Potter really taught us that talent is not just one person's doing, but it's actually a collective effort of everyone put together. Bravery is something that's commendable, and love is something that's irreplaceable. Harry Potter is a character that really got us all gripped onto so tightly that even today, if you ask anyone from the 90s or early 2000s what their favorite character is, they will stand up and say Harry Potter. Ronald Weasley. Ronald Weasley showed us that excellence doesn't always mean academics, it also means your co-curricular. Like, he excelled in the game of chess, something that taught him to think two steps ahead as to what can be done. Though he really used this talent only in the last book when he had to think of the basilisk fang to break a horcrux. But Ron is just adorable and lovable, and without him the trio would have just got so bored. So thanks to Ron that we laughed through the series, and we also experienced a little foolishness that might have been our reaction in many situations. Ron is so much like all of us here. Character that I learned the most from in the book, the most, I'm so serious about it, is Professor Umbridge. What I really learned from her is just don't be Professor Umbridge in life. So that's all, guys. I hope you really liked this video and you enjoyed it. And this is maybe the first of our series of exploring different characters from iconic books and learning life lessons out of what they had to leave behind for us. So see you all again with the next video. Forget to like, share, subscribe and hit the bell icon. See you soon.